Afternoon, my dear and precious friends, and we will be working on part two of the Rainbow Angel. And yesterday we did the first part where you see the background on the painting, and I wanted you to see how nice and muted the colors are. You can see them better now that they're dry. You can dry with a blow dryer, but I found if I am patient and I let them dry naturally on their own, they will do better. So this morning, during my prayer time, I was praying and asking the Lord what He wants to do with this painting. And it is just the coolest thing. I spend time in the morning every day praying. I set my timer and I pray for my friends and my family and Facebook. I pray for all of you who watch my channel. But the cool part is, the more time I spend with the Lord, the more clear and specific He is in my mind and in my heart. I actually see visions on the inside of what He wants His paintings to look like. So I give Him all the glory. These are meant to bring Him glory and make Him real to people in their lives. And whenever I paint, I do it as worship to the Lord. And anytime that you use your talents and gifts and abilities for the Lord, it's worship. So we have some beautiful soaking music, and I hope you will enjoy these videos. I'm going to do them in 10 or 15 minute segments, and I'll just keep adding them as we do them, and that way you can really enjoy them and take your time and paint along with me. I'm excited to have you. So I'll show you now with these paintings. I never know myself what I'm going to do with them, but you see this one. See up here, there's like a natural sky, and so what I want to do is I'm going to bring in some pretty grasses along this part, and I want to make like a field of flowers, and then I'm going to put some trees on this side, and I'll have the angel over here, and then I'll come back down and I'll do some flowers in the front. So you can see my color palette for today. Yesterday we did blues and purples and greens. Today we have teal blue, green, dark blue, pink, black, and white. So we're going to start with green, and I love this flat brush. And you know, you guys, I honestly don't know myself what these are going to come out like. That's the fun part. So we're just going to kind of bring some, and I kind of want to bring this down. I'll step back a little bit so you can see it. The thing about acrylics that I've kind of learned the hard way, they do dry really fast, but I often get impatient with them. And when you do that and you don't wait for the colors to completely dry, you end up getting muddy, really muddy looking paint. So the key to working with acrylics is it's layer upon layer upon layer. Step back a little so you can see. Peaceful to paint. Can't you just feel that? It's just so relaxing and enjoyable. And we're actually in the middle of moving, so moving can be so stressful, as you know. We're excited because we're going to be living closer to our grandchildren, only a mile away from them, and it's such a gift. We've been waiting for that for 12 years, but it's still very stressful. So the painting is very relaxing. It gives me time just to be quiet, just enjoy the peacefulness of it. Your painting into thirds, so the foreground in the front is where a lot of the detail will be, and then the part in the middle is going to be like a field of flowers, like I was telling you guys, and then the trees will go on the left hand side, and then in the back it's going to be the sky. So I need to put just a little more paint down in the bottom. You can't really make any mistakes with acrylics, because if you don't like something, all you have to do is paint on. It's a cool part. And then yesterday I did go along the edges. This is a canvas that has the edges on it. So I did go ahead and paint that the same color. Dry, and I will be back with you guys a little bit later. I will tell you a tip. I'm going to get a wet paper towel and place it over my paints. It will keep them from drying out, and then I can continue to use them. But I will see you guys in a little while. Right? So we are going to work on some mountains in the background, and I'm going to be using some of the blue with my flat brush. I'm just kind of sketching in. Going to be in the background, so I don't really care if they are prominent. They just, every little detail just adds a little bit more. And I'll just step back a little bit so you can see. Just a touch of black. Strokes to kind of blend it in. And I mix the dark blue and the black together. It kind of makes the black not quite so strong and dominant. A little bit, and the glare won't be there when we, you know, when it dries. So we're just going to let these dry, and we're almost ready to start working on the trees and the flowers. And it's always so much fun. The more details you add, the picture just starts to come to life. So I can't wait to start working on it. And I will be back in a little bit. So we are going to be working on a fun part. I'll show you guys so you can see the mountains and the little grass that we put in. It's all nice and dry. And then we're going to work on the flowers. So what I'm going to do, I'll show you. This brush is just a boar bristle brush. And then what we do is we're just going to kind of dab a little bit of the paint. You want like a dry brush effect. See? And you can just make the prettiest little flowers. Try a little bit of pink. Do a tinge of blue. It's important to keep the brush dry so you can get the effect that you want to make these little flowers. So I just kind of tap in it against the plate. I like to use the paper plate. This part I'm working on here, the paintbrush is actually wet because I had to rinse off the color, and you can see it's not quite as defined, but that's okay because it's going to look really soft, and I'll go back and put some more colors on it. So we're just going to kind of step back and take a look and just see. And I'm going to get another brush that's kind of dry. A little bit bigger, see? kind of just following the little green, like the shape of the hills that we did before. See, when you look back, it's starting to look like there's some little hills on there. Sparkles, and just I want it to be just almost like a whimsical look to it. Just feel the peaceful music. It's so relaxing doing this. I hope you're enjoying it, and I so appreciate you taking the time and spending time with me. And I hope that as you do it, you'll feel your own place of joy. You can see this technique is not hard at all. Anybody can do it. And we can see kind of what the picture's starting to look like. And we'll stop this for now. I'll be back in a few minutes. Welcome back, everyone. This is part 3 of our rainbow angel. And you can see we did, part 1 was the background, and then part 2, we started the mountains and the flowers. And so we're gonna pick up where we left off with the other video. So this one is part 3. And I'm gonna go in now and just put some pretty pink and purple flowers to kind of fill in, because we're working on getting the background, and then we'll start to add the details. And the fun part about acrylics is every little bit that you add adds more and more detail to your beautiful painting. And when you pull it all together, it's going to be amazing. And I was telling you guys, about a week or so ago, I woke up and I had a dream. And I saw a beautiful rainbow angel, and so that's what I'm working on. This one's gonna be. So right now, I can't capture, to be honest, they're so beautiful. I don't have the artistic ability to be able to capture them, but it was just the most beautiful, incredible angel. She shimmered like the rainbow. And it was neat because it was the night before I was going to preach a Mother's Day sermon, and I looked it up to see what that meant. And it meant the glory of the Lord, and it also meant peace and hope. So I thought, what an amazing thing to see. This brush is a boar bristle brush, and I'm just tapping. That's how easy this technique is. You just tap it in where you want it. Different purple color. I'm not really liking this one as much. That's actually one of my favorite things to do. And what I do is I'm just gonna bring, you make like some really pretty leaves in the front. And you can see I dragged some of this other color into it. Tendrils. And I'm left-handed, so I'm trying to hold the camera at the same time I'm painting, just so you can see it, because my hand kind of gets in the way. These paintings are going to look at like they kind of evolve as I'm working on them, so I have just as much fun as you guys do looking at them, because I truly don't know what they're going to look like when I get done. I don't plan them, I just kind of let them be what they're going to be, and that's what makes it so joyful. Okay, so we'll step back a little bit, you can see all the detail in it. Some purple flowers, and you see I have just the same dry brush. Actually, I'm gonna get one that's dry because that one is wet. So this one's a little bit bigger. These are boar bristle brushes, and it's a dry brush effect. You really want the brush to be dry. And I'm just tapping. The canvas is on a portable stand and it keeps moving, you guys, and I'm sorry, I'll just keep moving it up. And I'm gonna just kind of step back and you can see it's really starting to take shape. You know, I wanted to tell you guys, the angels are greatly at work in your lives too. I've got two books that I've published. One's called The Angel Seer. That was the first one. The second one, I went back and added more stories and more details, and that one's called Angelic Encounters. And then what I'm gonna do, I'm getting ready to do a third book because I've seen there's probably 11 more stories. So what I'm gonna do is this painting that I'm working on, it's gonna be the cover. And then I'll tell you guys the information when I get it all done. But when you read the stories, if you decide you want to, you'll see that the angels are greatly at work in all of our lives. God sends them every day to help us. They send messages, they answer prayers, they protect us. And I want to say, you guys, I am nobody special. And I think the only reason why the Lord lets me see them is because He knew I would be willing to write about them. So, you know, you kind of take the risk that people think you're crazy, and I'm not. I'm not on medications. I don't hear voices. I'm a pretty much ordinary person. I'm a grandmother, a wife, a mother. I'm a minister. I'm an ordained Assembly of God minister. So it's not that I'm anybody special, and I'm not any more spiritual than anybody else. I'm just obedient. And so I think sometimes that's really all the Lord is looking for. He asks us to do things. Sometimes we're not comfortable. You know, it's kind of out of our comfort zone. But if it brings Him glory and it lets you know He's real, then it's worth it. And we're just going to step back. We're getting a really pretty field of flowers. That's exactly what I wanted. We'll put some blue ones back here. All I'm doing is tapping. This is just the easiest stroke ever, and you can see how pretty that is. Just adds dimension. Just a tiny little bit. This one's a little tiny one. I'm gonna put a little stitch of yellow. It's just a tiny hint of orange. I love flowers. There's nothing I love better than looking at a field of wildflowers. It's looking really pretty. I really like the way it's coming out. Amazing gifts, and you know, He gives all of you guys special things to enjoy. We all have talents and abilities. He loves us so much that He gives us things that we can enjoy. So you may have like the gift of hospitality. You might like inviting people into your house. You may be a good housekeeper, and that may be your gift. You may be someone that can cook or sew or encourage. We all have our special things, and you know, the cool part is none of us are the same, and we are to enjoy the gifts that God gave us. So I just want to encourage you, find out what they are, ask the Lord to show you, and He will. He's faithful. He loves us all the same. He loves you so much that He sent His Son to die for you. And if you don't know Jesus, I would encourage you, just get to know him. Ask him to make himself real. And all you have to do is say this simple prayer. Just say, "Dear Lord, I ask you to forgive me and make me new. And I ask you to make yourself real to me." It's as simple as that. And it's not about a church. It's about a relationship with the King of Kings. He wants to be our friend. And we'll just step back and look at it. So we have the flowers done. Then the next part we're going to work on will be the trees. I'm going to have a tree come up here, I think, and a bigger tree in the front, and then we'll start to work on the angel. So we're getting there. We are getting ready to start the trees. There's going to be three of them. I'm just going to bring it back a little bit so that you can see. So what I'm going to do is I'll put one tree here, and the biggest one probably either here or there. It depends on how it looks, maybe here. And then I'm going to be putting the angel on this area. So what I'm trying to do is create like a, almost it'll draw your eye going in that direction. And the trees are much easier than you would think. So the tree in the background is going to be the lightest. So you can see I'm mixing the black with white. So the first tree will be the lightest one. And then we're just going to start with a straight line. And then the second tree, I'm going to add a little more black to it. That one's going to go right here. And then the last tree, I'm just going to rinse my brush. And the last tree is going to be the dark, the regular black. So we're just going to put that one here. And it's kind of, I don't want them to be exactly straight because they won't look like a real tree. And I'm going to turn on my music so we can enjoy together worshiping the Lord. And then I just want to go back and we're going to start to add the branches. So I have this is like a little flat brush. And if you drag them out like this, see how you can get the little fine tips on the end of the branches? And you can just kind of crown it. All about what you like and what looks good to you. So you can see that we have the first tree. And we'll just pull that a little bit and let you see kind of how the painting started to come along. And then we're going to work on the second tree. And that one's a little bit darker than the first one. And then the last one's gonna be just a solid black. And you can see the reason why you start from the back and go forward, because you're gonna add more details in the front. Let's just take a look back and we'll see the pretty trees that we have. So we will stop. This will be the end of this video. The next one, I'll show you how to put the leaves on, and then we're going to be starting our pretty rainbow angel. Thank you so much for spending this time with me, and I've really enjoyed this. I'll be back with the next video. Welcome back. This is Pastor Bonnie, and we are working on part four of the live painting tutorial. I decided to break these up into smaller pieces because there's so much detail in this painting. It would probably be 2 hours long, so it's much easier to put this into little bits and pieces, and you can stop the video and follow along. So we are going to be starting with part four, and we are going to be working on the leaves on the trees. Sorry, excuse my fingers for this one. And I'm going to be using a fan brush for this one, and then you can see the colors are purples and blues, so I'm just going to pick up some of this purple, and we'll start with the back tree, and you just kind of tap it on. I love purple because this is kind of like a twilight scene, and the purple kind of lends itself to that. The Well, you can see all the detail, and this of course will look a lot better when it's dry, but this will kind of give you an idea. And then I'm just going to kind of pull it back a little bit so you can see how pretty that tree is. It's got some beautiful color in it. And I think I might just go over the top and add, this is like a sort of a magenta color. So what you do when you're working on the leaves is you go from light to dark. So you always start with the dark color first, and then you put the lighter color over the top of it. I may go back and I'll probably put some really pretty pink after this dries. So we have the first one done. I'll actually zoom in a little bit so you can see it. Like I said, the detail will show up a lot better when we get done with the, when it dries and I add the new color on it. We're gonna be working on the second tree, and I want that one to continue kind of with the purple theme, but I'm gonna use a little bit of blue in it because it's in the shadows, so this one's gonna be a little darker. And I want the, I'm trying to make the leaves a little different from each other. And it's the same thing, we're using our fan brush again. Just kind of step back a little bit. It won't have that shine on it. Let me turn it up this way so you can see a lot better. And then I'm going to use just a little titch of light blue on the edges. You always want to go from dark to light. Let's see if I can stand up so you can see it better. Our two trees. I'm gonna have to let those two dry because the third tree will have the most definition, and the third tree we're gonna use greens in it, and if I try to do it now, both those colors, all the colors will kind of blend and mix together and it'll look muddy. So we're gonna stop the video for a little while. I'll be back after they dry and we'll continue with the third tree. Now we are gonna start the front tree. So we're doing the same technique. I'm just going to tap in some green branches. I'm just using a fan brush, and you can see how simple this is. All the techniques I use are very, very simple that anybody can do. And you see how we had the purple in the background, then we had the blue for the center tree, and then we're bringing the green forward. So you want your dominant colors to be in the front. I just love how it makes like delicate, pretty little branches using the fan brush. little bit so you can see. Just a tiny little bit of yellow mixed with it, just to give it a little highlight. You go back, you pick up the white and kind of tap in pretty little branches with it. Hint of yellow, mix it with the green. So you can see what it looks like. So that will conclude this section, and then the next section we'll be working on is going to be the angel. I can't wait to get started and see how it's going to come out. I appreciate spending this time with you. We are going to be starting the angel. This is always my favorite part. So you always want to make sure you start with clean water, because this is going to be white that we paint with. And I'm going to be sketching out the face and the body first. And so we're going to start right in here. Pretty neck. just kind of sketching the angel out. It'll look different when I get done, but you can always paint over it. Usually I do these as stills, but my hand, it's because I'm left-handed, I'm trying to hold on to the camera while I do this so you can see it, get my hand out of the way. How these are going to come out, so it's just, I have just as much fun working on this as I do showing you how to do it. Stop for just a minute because my hand's getting tired holding this. I'm gonna put in some more details and then I'll show you in a few more minutes. Let me just zoom out before I do so you can see how she kind of fits in the picture. So it's gonna be, this one's gonna be really pretty. So we got some more detail, and I don't usually paint them. You can see it's, she's got a lot of white. This, but I'm gonna go back and put some rainbow colors in. So now we're gonna start the wings. just sketching these. I'll come back and put a lot more detail. So the trick is to water down the paint for this part because we're going to go back and add much more detail. Just step back and see what it looks like. And here it is with the whole picture. There'll be a lot more detail. It's starting to look muddy right now because I need to let the layers dry so I can go back and add some more. So we're gonna take a break. As soon as it dries, we'll come back and work on it. While we're waiting for the angel to dry, we're gonna do the tree. We're gonna start a tree on the other side. So this one is going to be part 5, and I'm just doing little, like 10 to 20 minute videos, because this is probably one of the largest paintings I've done. This one's a stretched canvas, and you can see it's really starting to come together nicely, but I want to put in another tree on the other side just to kind of balance it out. So this one we're going to bring over here. And I want to have like going off the side. And then I have a different brush I like to use. This one's a flat brush. Actually, I don't like that one. And if you push the paint from the sink, that's what I was looking for. You get the nice little branches on the end. Beautiful magnolia tree. So that's what we're going to work with. I just have a fan brush like we did the other ones. And my brush is wet, so it gives like a muted effect. I'm going to come back after it dries and we'll wait till the fan brush is dry, and then we're going to put in some more details on top of it. Thank you. and really whistling. It's like a little bit of light on the top of the branches. Don't you just love that music? Jesus loves me, this I know. Just, I love that. That's one of my favorite songs. Now I'm just gonna water, I'm going to make the paint just a little bit lighter with the pink and the white. So you see how I took the same pink and just add a little bit more white. Starting to take shape. We're getting there. It's going to be beautiful when we get it done. We are going to work some more on the tree on the left of the angel. And we're going to try the same technique that we did with the pink one. So you can see here it is with the fan brush. And I'm going to start with the dark green. So we're just doing a little of the same technique to the tree, and you can see I've added some green and yellow. And I'm using the same dry brush technique. It's actually a bristle brush. Back so you can see what it looks like. See how the trees are starting to come to life? And I probably will do the same thing with the back one just to give it a little more dimension. Thank you. Welcome back, everybody. We are starting number six part. I've broken it down into little mini videos so that these won't be so long and you can enjoy it. And we're going to do a little more work on our pretty angel. I'm just going to bring it in a little bit closer so you can see the detail. I really enjoy how this one's coming out. It looks so pretty. One of my favorite things to do is to put little dots and sparkles on the wings, and I'll show you how I do that. So we're just going to do like little dots, and then you take your finger and you smooth it with your finger. It makes it look like her wings are sparkling. And this angel, what I'm going to do is I'm going to paint this one with rainbows in her. I'm not sure yet if I'm going to do it in her dress or in her wings. But I told you guys earlier, this was actually an angel I saw a couple weeks ago. And the night before I was going to preach a Mother's Day sermon, this beautiful angel came in my room one night. It was just incredible. And that I don't always see them with wings. Usually how they're dressed is the message. But this one actually had wings. And this one, there was just such a sense of love and peace. And I looked it up later, and it meant the glory of the Lord and peace and hope. So that just blessed me because I was getting ready to preach the next day, and I wanted it to be God's anointing on it. So it was, and God is so faithful. So then now you go back and you put a little dot in the middle, and see how it kind of highlights the ones that you... Actually, these need to be bigger. It's a little bit too big, but we'll fix it. You can draw little sparkles in them. I love my beautiful worship music, and I so appreciate you taking the time to spend with me while we do this together. It's joyful to share the gifts God's given me with other people. And I hope you feel blessed and you get encouragement from the things that we talk about together. And I wanted to tell you, you know, if you guys have any prayer requests, I spend a couple hours a day in prayer. So if you just post it in the description box, I would be glad to pray for you. God answers prayers and He hears our prayers. And you know, the Bible talks about that God thinks about each and every one of us so much every day that it can't be counted. That's how much He loves us. See, so some of these are all different sizes, the little dots. And I'll step back in a minute so you can see it. These I'll go back like and put a little dot in the middle. Just makes a little twinkle. you can put these randomly wherever you like them, where they feel like they look good to you. So I'm going to go ahead and I'll stop the video and I'm going to do the other wing. But before I do, I'll pull back. See the difference? If you compare the two wings, see how the pretty little sparkles add so much? So what I'm going to do, and it's the same technique, so what I'll do is I'm going to do sparkles on this wing, and I'm also going to put sparkles down in the bottom of her dress. So I will stop the video and then I'll show you what it looks like when it gets done. I took my paintbrush and I dipped it in paint, and then you tap two brushes together, and I wanted to get the little sparkles, and you can see on the wings. These were the ones where I put the dots that I just showed you how to do. And then I'm going to go back and add some more of the stars and the sparkles and the little bit bigger ones. So I'll stop it and I'll show it to you in just a minute when I get it done. But I wanted to show you, it's one of my favorite techniques, and you can see it's starting to look like there's sparkles around the angel, and that's exactly what I wanted. And then I'll put them in just like I did on the wings. I won't take time to show you on the video because you've already seen me do it on the wings. But as soon as I get it done, we'll come back and I'll show you what it looks like. We're making progress with our pretty little angel, and I just want to show you guys what it looks like. See, with all the pretty sparkles, I went back and added a little more white to her dress, and then I tapped, you take two paintbrushes and tap them together to get the spatters, and then I went back and did the little sparkles and stars. So I'll just step back a little bit and let you see how it's coming along. So we're actually making progress on this little angel. I do want to go back and do a little bit of shading with the tree, so I'm just gonna take the brush, just see if we can add a little bit of dimension and texture. I'm just using a fine tip brush. I'm actually gonna water it down a little bit. I have so enjoyed spending this time with you guys. It's just been so much fun, and I hope you've enjoyed it as much as I have. Peaceful and pretty, listening to the music, worshiping the Lord together. So you notice I'm putting the light on the same side of the branches, because it kind of gives it more of a three-dimensional look. We're going to put a little bit. And I go back and kind of soften it up a little bit. Bring it closer to the edge. Just a little more water in that. I don't don't really like that little spot right there, so we're just gonna kind of ease it off a little. And then see how that gives the tree just a little more life to it. And then we're going to do the same with this one. And you notice I have the light going in the same direction. You kind of want the wood to look knobby. Just take a look back. See? Makes the trees look so much nicer. This one, I think I want to decrease that white though. I don't like it quite like that. And the next part we're going to do, excuse my fingers. We're going to do the next part is the last part, which is kind of the funnest part because we're going to put some flowers down around the tree to the left, some grasses and flowers, and we've got our painting almost done. Thank you so much. I'll be back.
We're back. This is going to be number 7. We've done 6 that are finished already, and like I was telling you guys earlier, I just wanted to break them into little pieces. It would have been a super long video otherwise. So now I'm getting ready to make some grasses down at the base of this tree using my fan brush. It's just a beautiful technique. Put a little bit of dark in there. And then you're gonna go back over with the light on top. Fan brush I'm going to use. I guess I'll have to rinse this one. Here, I'm shaking. And we just want to dry it before we use it so that there'll be a little more. So I'm just using a sponge. I'm gonna put some two. brushes. It's nice and dry. These are just an oval shaped petal. They're really simple to make. And then we're going to go over here and do a couple on this side too. Purposely making these so that you can still see the sparkles through them. See? And then we're going to do some white ones. Thank you. sometimes I like the white. It kind of just breaks up the color a little bit across the bottom. So just if you can draw stick figures, you pretty much can draw these. It's pretty good for doing it. I dragged my hand in it. That's one of the troubles about being a lefty. I'm always having to go back and fix stuff. That's okay. It'll look better the next time. Got a pretty little flower garden. I might want to put a few on this side too. I'm gonna step back a little bit and see how it looks. I think I'm gonna stop this video and I'm gonna get some blue paint and we'll put some pretty blue flowers in. It's been so much fun working with you. And I'm just gonna pull back and you can see all the pretty detail. And I want to just fix this a little bit up here because it just looks like a straight line. So I'm going to go back and do that. And I want to add a little more of the white flowers across here. And then we're going to put some finishing touches and then we'll do the rainbow wings. And I so appreciate it. It's been joyful doing this. And I appreciate you taking the time. There's all kinds of other painting ones too. I have all the angels are on my channel. So if you want to try some more, there are other ones that are on there. You are more than welcome to try them. I actually sell these, the originals. This one will be available for sale. I have two websites. I have one called The Father's Market at Etsy.com, but I just started a new one for just the angel paintings. So I actually will sell the originals. And that one is Angel Songs Art Studio at Etsy.com, and that's new. I just started that one. So you're more than welcome to check those out. I'll post the links in the description box. And these are originals. This is all there is of them. And I'll also post the links so that you can check out Angel Songs. Oh, sorry. It's actually, well, I do have a book called Angel Songs. It's a devotional. But I have the one about the angelic experiences. It's called Angelic Encounters Enlisting Help from Heaven. That's on Amazon. So you're welcome to check those out. But there are the people who have read those have been so blessed, because you can see how angels are at work in your own life. And the fun part, I get testimonies all the time about the books, and people tell me that they speak to them specifically, which is so cool, I think. And God does that. He's so good. He wants us to know how much He loves us. So He talks to us specifically about our own life. The same, different people can read the same book and they will see something different in it. And that book also has my personal testimony in it. The Lord asked me just to be really transparent, and I will tell you, it was not easy to do. Sometimes He asks us to do things that are hard, but it's been so joyful, and I'm so glad that I did it. And there have been many, many lives touched, and that's really all I care about. So if it doesn't matter about me, then that's the way I want it to be. God has just been so faithful to me and blessed me so much. I have an amazing marriage and I have wonderful children. You just couldn't ask for anything more. I'm just kind of breaking that line up a little bit so it doesn't look... Actually, I think I'm going to use my fan brush. With them. Just little dots you can see. Just kind of put them wherever they look good to you. Center.
always get them exactly in the center because it makes them look a little more natural. Just take a look. Sure looks pretty, doesn't it? I'll come back a little further so you can see the mountains. So you can see we started with the background, put the mountains in, did the field of flowers, added the trees. You see layer upon layer upon layer. And I'm sorry you guys because I thought I was filming it and it wasn't on, but you can see I've taken pastel colors and all I've done is just water them down and put layer upon layer upon layer. And I'll let you look kind of close, you can see. So what I did is I've just made them really watery and just, you know, putting a little touches here and there where I want them. A little titch of green, a little titch of pink, blue. But I really like how this one's coming out. And it was just what I wanted. I wanted the colors just to be soft and muted. And I have another story that I was going to tell you. I actually saw another angel that looked similar to this one. My daughter was expecting a baby, and she had lost a baby, so she was nervous. And I was nervous because I was a registered nurse for a lot of years. Sometimes you have to keep your opinions to yourself. And so this one particular night, same as always, I went to bed not thinking about anything spiritual. And I woke up in the night, I heard this noise like... I almost felt like, almost like a sheet flapping in the breeze. That's the best way to describe it. It was an actual noise. So I was startled and I woke up and sat up in bed and there was this angel that looked just like this one. And it was fluttering through my room and it was all these colors, just like I'm showing. And it was almost like, you know, when you look at a dragonfly in the sun, how pretty their wings look, that's what it looked like. And so I was startled, but it was like it was a messenger angel. I was given the understanding that it was a messenger angel. And the message that she delivered, and this one was a female form. So usually when I see angels, they're androgynous. They don't look male or female. They're beautiful. But this one was a female-shaped form. And I felt like the message was everything was going to be okay, even though my daughter was spotting and we were worried about it. So the next day, we went to the doctors, and sure enough, that was the report we got, that the baby was safe. And we ended up, she had the baby, well, probably 4 or 5 months later, she had a little girl. And so the angels come and they minister to us sometimes when we're sleeping. Sometimes they, you know, they talk to us sometimes. I don't know. It's like I said, it's just been amazing, the experiences I've had. And, you know, like I said, it's just incredible. So I got the wings the way I wanted. And we're going to pull back so you can see this beautiful rainbow angel. And I really love how this has come out. And... I'm gonna go ahead and I will sign my name on the bottom because we're finished. And then I'll take a picture so I can post it at the end and you'll see it. I'm gonna shellac it when it's dry and I'll post a picture. And if you wanna purchase this one, I think I told you, I can't remember if I told you in the last segment, I have a new website called Angel Songs Art Studio at Etsy.com. So all these will be on there, these original paintings. But I so appreciate you spending time, and thank you so much for helping me make this beautiful rainbow angel. And I pray that you'll feel the presence of the Lord and the peace and the excitement and the joy. And thank you very much. You take care.